Hey guys, welcome back to Pokemon Sapphire. In this part, you may be wondering why I'm in the Fiery Path for seemingly no reason, and that is because I actually want to catch the Fire-type Pokemon that I want. I've decided on Torkoal, and that's because I liked him best out of the other option of Numel and Camerupt. And also we're in here because I can actually do something in here that I haven't done previously. And of course, the first thing I run into is a Numel. Now, I don't believe Numel learns Flamethrower by itself upon leveling up, so that was a big reason as to why I didn't really want him. And I don't know, I just thought Torkoal would be a better addition to the team as opposed to Numel. What is this? TM6. What's TM6? What is that? Hold on. That's not toxic. It is toxic. Okay. It's actually a good TM. I'm glad I came in here. There's also Firestone down there, I think, as well. Now, Torkoal is kind of uncommon, I believe. So we're going to be running into, I believe, Zubats, Slugmas, and Numels, mostly in here. And I actually kind of thought about getting Slugma as my Fire-type Pokemon, but then I decided against it because Slugma and Magcargo aren't that good at all, basically. I feel bad for the poor Slugma family, but it's just not that good. Hopefully I'll be able to find a Torkoal eventually. If not, I mean, I'll just edit it out and come back once I find one. I'm Manectric out just so she can paralyze. Use Thunder Wave on him or her. I think Torkoals can be both male or female. So we've gotten everything that there is to get in here. So now I just want to hope that I run into a Torkoal so I can catch it. And then we can go to Mount Pyre and actually continue with the game. But no such luck so far. Another Numel. I don't want you on my team, I'm sorry. I thought about it, but I decided against it. So please stop showing up. Just give me a Torkoal. Torkoal? Please? No, a Grimer! Forgot that these things are in here too. I actually really like Grimer. Grimer and Mucker, pretty decent Pokemon in my opinion, I like them. I like them better than I like the Koffing family. That's just me. I actually thought about getting a Bagon or Bagon, however you say that cute little dinosaur's name. I actually thought about getting him and in the end having a Salamence, but Salamence or Shelgon evolves into Salamence at level 50, I believe, and I didn't really want... Oh, cool, Torkoal. I didn't really want to have a Pokemon that evolved into its final evolution so late, because I don't even know if all of my Pokemon are going to be level 50 by the time I get to the Elite Four. So, that was the reason behind that. Plus, I wouldn't be able to get him until really super late in the game, because you need to have Waterfall because you find Bagons, Bagons, whatever, deep in Meteor Falls. So I just figured it would be best to go for a Torkoal. And holy crap, that almost killed him. But he's paralyzed and now in red, so that should be prime catching right here. I should use a Pokeball because why not? Why not use a Pokeball? You're not good enough for an Ultra Ball. I don't waste the money. Alright, we got him. Now, the only problem with this is poor Torkoal is level 15, and I honestly should have gotten him a lot sooner, but whatever. We'll make it work. Torkoal generates energy by burning coal. It grows weaker as the fire dies down. When it is preparing for battle, this Pokemon burns more coal. I do not have a nickname for him. At least I think it was a him. Could be wrong. Alright, let's get the hell out of here. And actually, oh, there's a Machop in here. That just kind of makes me want a Machamp, but I already have a Hariyama, so get out of here. Maybe one of these days, I'll kind of be a jerk and then like use a Pokemon that you can only evolve fully and trade and just kind of hack it in. I thought about doing that just so I could use certain Pokemon, but ultimately decided against it. But I really want a Machamp. I love Gengar a ton. I love... Who else is it? Golem. I've actually never used a golem on my team before, because back when I was that young, I never had anybody to trade with. Like, my older brother, or one of my older brothers, had a Game Boy, and they would like never trade with me. He would get really mad if I played his game. And it bugged me. It bugged me a lot. Let's move Pokemon. Do we need Meryl? What do you have? You have Rock Smash. You have Rock Smash. That could be a problem. We'll place you there. And we'll look at our Pokemon. Does Clamps now serve? Clamps does now serve. I need no strength. I need to teach someone Rock Smash. Because I'd really like to still be able to get rid of those pesky rocks. So let's see who can learn it. Almost everybody, actually. I think I'm gonna give it to Torkoal, just because. I don't think Torkoal's really gonna learn any other moves, like HM-wise, that'll muck up his move pool. So I'm just gonna get rid of Curse, because I don't like Curse. Curse was really annoying on Ghost types, though. It's a very interesting move. And who was it? Morty? His name was Morty, right? Gen 2 4th gym leader? He had, like, Ghost types? Morty? I think that was him. I'm actually gonna switch Pokemon around to, Makit needs to be leveled up. And I'm actually, I think I have an EXP share with me. I do. I'm gonna give this to Torkoal. I'll probably train him off screen after this recording session, but for the time being, he's gonna leech off of experience from my other Pokemon, so. Let's head off to Mount Pyre really fast. I actually went back and, like, defeated those two or three trainers that I hadn't beaten previously. Let's just ignore the Zigzagoon, although I could probably defeat it and maybe level up or get closer to a level up. And actually, up there's the Safari Zone. Maybe after Mount Pyre, we'll come back and do the Safari Zone. And this Pokemon right here, I've thought about using a Shuppet and a Banette as well. I usually don't use Ghost-type Pokemon, but I think if I were to, it would probably have to be Duskull and Dusclops. Duskull and Dusclops are super freaking freaky, but they're just so good. They're probably my favorite Ghost-type Pokemon, besides Gengar. And I prefer them over the Shuppet Banette family. And actually, if we go down here, if you remember back, there was that the Berry Master's house. And this is actually the route to get to the Berry Master's house. I actually might do this route on my own because there's nothing of importance on it as far as I remember, other than a few items and some trainers. So that's where I'll probably train Torkoal a little bit, but we're gonna go to Mount Pyre. And it's just a graveyard for Pokemon, so depressing. Did you come to pay your respect to the spirits of departed Pokemon? You must care for your Pokemon a lot. This place is just sad. And I think this woman up here gives you a spell tag. Oh yeah, and there are wild Pokemon in here. And they're usually ghost types. So let's get out of here, Shuppet. I'm actually going to use a repel. Because I don't want to keep running into them. This place is sad enough as is. I don't wanna see like potential dead Pokemon. Oh, a cleanse tag, not a spell tag. I think it makes it so you run into Pokemon less frequently. And we actually need to go outside and climb the outside of Mount Pyre as opposed to climbing the inside of it. The inside just has more trainers and a few more items, I believe. And I actually think you can get a Vulpix here. I think. If you can, I don't know, Torkoal or Vulpix? I have a super repel up, so even if there is a Vulpix out here, I can't run into it right now because I don't think they're that high of a level. But I have a Firestone, and I don't know what TM that was. The dog is like barking outside my... What TM was it? I wasn't even paying attention. Was it 48? I think it might have been 48 skill swap. I was not even paying attention. I'm actually... I'm gonna run back and forth because I totally spaced out that you had to, that you had to go outside and not climb through the actual tower itself. So I'm gonna run around, I'm gonna let this super repel wear off like that, and I'm actually going to switch back to Manectric just in case there are Vulpixes out here. Because I'm so on the fence about it. Because Torkoal, I think, is a decent Pokemon, but Vulpix, I've never used a Vulpix on my team ever. And I think there are Vulpix in this patch of grass, but I'm not sure if it's in Pokemon Sapphire. It could be just an Emerald or a Ruby exclusive, or there could be Vulpix because I just ran into one. I'm actually going to try to catch this because, like I said, I'm completely undecided and I really don't know. No Will-O-Wisps, that sucks.